If nothing else, it makes us think.
You cannot plan for the next 5 years. You have to look decades and generations down the road.
Saddle up and get ready to ride.
We have a lot of challenges related to traffic flow and balancing cars and pedestrians through the downtown corridor.
We've had to work with innovation, especially with Georgia Tech, and coming up with ways that will ease traffic flow, get people home, spend more time with their family.
As we can't expand Main Street, because we have a railroad on one side and a bunch of historic shops on the other, making sure that we are able to move cars through the area effectively while not impeding pedestrian priority is a huge issue for us.
Two things excite me about this project. One is illuminating the pedestrian safety crosswalks, and also the traffic monitoring sensors will help us better understand the flow of traffic as it increases or decreases. I'm excited about the possibility of an app on someone's phone telling them where a parking spot is as they drive to downtown.
We want to be different. We want to figure out what it means for a city to be leaning into the future, be a smart city, and be reactive to what's happening around us.
It's been great so far working with Georgia Tech on the walking school bus program. Over the last 10 years, the city of Milton has put in a lot of infrastructure to make it more accessible to walk to school. I believe parents want that experience for their kids, but this alleviates some fears and concerns, both with safety and accountability. This has brought it to the next level with technology and tracking and promoting getting kids and parents on board to walk to school. The feedback I've gotten has been very positive. The parents are enjoying it just as much or more than the kids are. It greatly benefits the city of Milton with traffic, but it will definitely continue to help alleviate traffic concerns in the mornings and the afternoons.
Smart cities has been critical to us being able to identify different ways to innovate and try to continue to improve so many areas of our community. There's not a doubt in my mind that what that's going to allow us to do as we continue to gather more data is to reshape the way we look at quality of life, to economic impact, to how to blend pedestrian traffic with multimodal traffic. One of the things that we heard from the community is the difference in people who have access to internet and online resources that so many people in our community don't. And right now, with people working from home, people being schooled from home, access to those types of services is absolutely essential. And even though we're working on just one small part of the uptown area with the Wi-Fi and the connectivity piece, I think it has an opportunity to serve as a catalyst for more investment and more innovation as we try to make sure that we cover the entire community.
We know that there's a phenomenal upside to being a smart city. It can be incorporated in so many ways and so many things to make you more efficient, to make you more effective, to make you more equitable and inclusive of the entire community. So finding a way that we can make information and smart technology available to underserved portions of our community raises equity and a feeling of inclusion and being part of a bigger whole. So we came up with the idea of a kiosk that can provide a variety of information, services, and technology that's available to the neighborhood. Our motto is working together. So here we're smarter together if we make this information available and get people involved in the process.
First, I'd say congratulations.
The other cities should be ready to embrace innovation. They're going to be exposed to ideas that they never really even thought of.
Cities that are about to be selected need to know that they're plugging into one of the most high-powered research institutes in the world.
I would tell anybody who is anticipating this grant in the coming year to saddle up and get ready to ride, because they're going to be challenged.
You will learn more, your community will learn more, and Georgia Tech is a great partner to work with you in figuring out ways to do some of your local government services.
It'll be a win-win situation.